yeah, it's kind of amazing how they're doing food repairs. And my left was the original. This is from my second
lightning rod.
Okay. So everything's on the left, so I'm choosing my right. I think this is the iPhone 6. It came in for backlight repair. Oh, this is where stuff is at. Alright, so I don't know if I'm gonna be able to finish this repair on time and in the video, because any kind of shit can happen when, so I'm cursing a lot, when you do a backlight repair. You see that little Apple logo? I can see it, I don't know if you can see it. It's like there. Alright, so we confirm it's a backlight problem. And I'm gonna turn the phone off when I do this. And before I do that, I really want to clean this area. Sure, the phone is freaking off. That was weird. I saw backlight just now. Nope, backlight still dead. Okay, so the phone is off. Taking the pantaloupes. I'm gonna do this repair on a giant magnet. This magnet is so strong, it's gonna suck everything. See, the screw doesn't fly anyway. I tried to flick it, it doesn't go anywhere. I'm not sure why not. This one's not coming out. I need a little help. There we go.
Okay, so now,
since the screen is somewhat intact, I have to use one of the suction cup things to get the iPhone 6. So these suction cups is specifically designed for this. I'm gonna have to take this off, even though this is like a new screen, I guess. Okay, there we go. And just hold the top and point. It's open. Remove the suction cup and you can just put it with your hand or something. I don't know why this thing is sticking out. Somebody put glue on it. Why would I do that? Weird. Oh god. Okay. So many screws. This is why you need a screw mat. For some weird reason, I don't have one with me. Even though I sell that stuff. Strange, huh? So this is my new location where I don't have the school bag. Okay, just need to be very careful where you put these screws so you remember where they are. And you put it back. So for any kind of these repair, I have to get the battery off first. Be just careful when you do this because there's a lot of like resistor in there, the capacitors. The next thing is to get to the backlight filter. So that's where the spring is. I don't know if I'm gonna put these screws back because in my opinion, they are more trouble than they are worth, because when you screw them back, they really don't do anything, let's be honest. And when you screw them back, if you get the orientation wrong, which shouldn't happen, it can damage the board. So it's not just that, if you squish it too tight or too loose, this ribbon cable can get damaged and then this screen wouldn't work right. And this is already a replacement screen from the looks of it. Okay, so just keep this orientation in mind and put them aside. Now I need to look, see what's up with the backlight filter. I'm hoping it's just a filter because I don't really want to change the dial. That was hard to get to. I'm confused. What is this? Oh, the iPhone 6S. It's kind of annoying. How does it come with filters? I'm gonna get my fucking needle. There we go. I think it's a 20 gauge needle. There we go. It's a little bit damaged. Oh. I remember it was somewhere here. Up here. It's over here. I'll get this connector off. Well, I really need a freaking pink pick. Not sure if I have one. Where do I put it? One second. Yeah, half one. Something. Thank you. was gonna say, I don't have a pin pick. And I found a whole set. Great. Now I can actually do some stuff. Okay. So, dental picks. There. Oh, there we go, I see it. It's a button. You can see. I think this is the backlight filter. Right here. Right? I don't look burned though.
So let's see.
Does it work? This one work. The top one's gone. Doesn't work. And. It has a good connection to the connector, but no connection to the filter. No beeping and no resistance whatsoever. So
okay, so that connect, so that the filter like I expected, it's gone.
I'm not sure if I can do this with
the soldering tip, so I'm gonna replace the soldering tip with my soldering tip. The one I made. I also want to make sure I have this filter with me because I don't know if I bought any. Okay, goodbye. Weird Chinese made garbage. Two choices. One will work. Yeah, this one not gonna work. This need to be sharpened. This one might do it. You can buy these soldering iron tips on my website. I sell them, it's copper alloy. I sell, it's fine, the fine tip one. I sell them at $20 a piece because they be hard to make. Like, it's very time consuming. It takes me as much time to make one than doing a repair. So, technically, I should charge more actually because, like, I make more than $20 per repair. Sometimes only 20 actually, to be honest. But, it's just really hard to make them. Cause this, and you have to make it very fine and sharp. And in order to fit into this, it's not easy to do. Okay, see this glove keeps on breaking on the right hand. I think my hand might be too thick for this glove. This is the first glove, this is the second glove. I don't even use my right hand, it's kind of weird. Alright, so it's kind of a lot of time preparing. Now we're gonna do the soldering. I think the actual soldering is probably only 5 minutes. The prepping took forever. So I don't have all the tube with me. Since this is a new location. There we go.
ready. Iron's hot. Some flux. Just want to make sure you only remove that filter, nothing else, before you clean your soldering iron. Because if you remove something else and you clean your soldering iron and the other part you don't know what it is, then it's forever gone. It's gone forever. You can get it back. It'll be a problem. Okay. So tin the pads. Okay, the pads are ready. Now I need to go find a filter if I have one. Oh. Good. Found a gazillion of them. Okay. So it's really, really small. You want to buy a magnet mat for this, really. Because unless you have a gazillion of them, you're bound to lose these. They fly. So if you have a magnet, you just drop it out and you will get stuck on the magnet. And you won't lose it. Okay, just be careful. You don't want to put a back filter in, so make sure you have the working one. And throw away the old one. Like, your eyesight helps. Should be it. I'm just overkilling, I want to make sure it works. Here. So. Okay, I should do it. To test this, get a screen and put it on. I'm not sure, I think this is the camera and this is the iPhone 6s. The LCD and the touch connector is the same thing. I think this is actually, does it benefit you? I don't know. Because this connector is pretty long too. I was gonna say, if the connector is shorter as a result, then it will help for the repair people. Because Apple has a tendency using really long connector and it causes a lot of problems. about clicking it back correctly. Short person. But this connector is not that short, so I don't know if they solved that problem by using a shorter connector. Okay, so battery is plugged in, has on power. Let's see if backlight is fixed. Ta-da! We got backlight, so I was praying. Seriously, I was praying. I didn't have to change the dials. There are two dials and another like integrated IC chip, which is more dials inside iPhone 6 Plus. But in this case, it was just the backlight filter. So far, all the 6 Plus I got is just the backlight filter. I haven't been able to have to change the dials or IC yet. And not that difficult. It's just getting to it is kind of annoying because you have to get the fascia off. I have touch now. See? So that connector connect both the image and the touch, which I guess that makes sense because the whole screen. It's kind of like a Samsung now, isn't it? Samsung, I think this connector only it connects both image and touch together. So Apple is kind of copying Samsung, I think. Okay, that was it. That was easy. iPhone 6s. And if you got a symptom and problem, you got a little dim logo image, just no backlight whatsoever, you can send it to me and I'll fix this for you. Just like that. Hopefully yours doesn't have that little dials too, because there's two of them and I don't want to have to get to them, they're very hard to get to. And if you are doing this repair on your own, $20. Buy it from my website. It's the finest tip. The tip diameter on the tip is so fine. I don't think it's even 0.1 millimeter. Maybe 0.1 millimeter, but it's just really fine. And it will hurt when you tap on yourself. It's like a needle. Although it does warm up pretty quickly, so you need to file it or you can send it back and I can sharpen it for you. So if you buy your tip from me, just pay shipping. And it's like $2 both each way. If you buy like a gazillion of them, I can sharpen them for you to a limit, because this tip, each time you sharpen, it gets shorter and shorter. So if you buy like a set, maybe like, I'm thinking about selling like them like 5 or 10, although it is $20 each, but you can always send it back and I can sharpen them for you and you can reuse them many times. This is how I do things. So I make these and I sharpen them, and I sharpen them, and I sharpen them, and so on. So I can get like probably a good multiple time use, I don't know how many times, depends on each tips, out of these tips. Okay, thank you for watching. This is cyber.ilc.com. Here we go. This is my website. This is the iPhone 6 Plus backlight repair. Let's say goodbye with a logo. Unplug. Okay, yeah. Goodbye, Apple logo. See you in my next repair.